Logan. We're already on our sixth. We're already on our sixth episode, and I'll dive right into the colors: Titanium White, Baleu Blue, Prussian Blue. Here, I get it closer to you. Midnight Black, Van Dyke Brown, Dark Sienna, Alizarin Crimson, Sap Green, Chaotic Yellow, Indian Yellow, and Bright Red. Okay. I'll tell you what I have up here. I have a 16x20 inch. I have a 16x20 inch canvas. You could use any size you want. This, I just use this because it seems to fit the screen. And I grabbed some. I used a disposable foam brush and added some egg tempera. Egg tempera is used by using some powdery. Anything that's powdery, mixing with egg yolk. I did it down here, about here. Here I did the orange color up here a little bit too. And then I grabbed some liquid clear and bright red. Just a touch of liquid white mixed in it. And then with the disposable foam brush and left color, I just smacked it on the canvas. And I'll show you how to turn something this bad to something awesome. Hold on a second. I'm going to show you how to turn something this bad into nature's masterpiece. So, let's begin. So, I'm going to begin with this little brush. With this brush. No, you know, actually, we're going to go with this two-inch brush. I feel like it'll be a little better. And we're going to smooth out the entire canvas. Smooth it all out. I'm going to smooth out the entire canvas. No, this liquid clear is still wet. This liquid clear is still wet. Okay. Now we're going to grab the 1-inch brush. And let's see, we're going to go into some cat yellow. Titanium white. And some titanium white mixed. Bit of a brighter yellow. I like these bright yellows. They're very nice colors. I like these very bright yellows. They're good yellows. Alright, now where do you want your little summit? You know what? Sharpen your brush. Sometimes a little hair stick out. Want them all super, super sharp. Okay? Let's go up here. So you have to find where you want your sun. I want my sun right here. That's my sun. That's the sun. So a little white in there. And a little sun. A little more. Up here, a little more like a sun. Because right now that just looks like. That does not look like a sun. So I'm going to keep doing little circles until you have this little circle. There we go, I'm comfortable with that. So, now this is not the completed sun. If you wanted to do this, grab a knife, your finger. You could do this with a fan brush, a liner brush, or a filbert. But I'm gonna use my finger. So I'm gonna go right into titanium white. Pull some out on my finger. And we're gonna make a little circle. And this is the sun right here. There's our little sun. I'm gonna grab a little more. A little more and work outward. The sun looks a little better if it's round. Square sun will sort of bother you. And you have to clean your finger. Water down from a paper towel. Okay, now. Let's Let's make a little background sky. So with that, I'm gonna grab this color, grab our dirty brush, or some Indian yellow, just a little bit, and then go on a bright red. Go on to some red, and just some red, and a touch, okay, yellow, maybe a little more, then just a touch. Let's turn it into some cad yellow. Bright, since you put bright red, this color is not transparent anymore. Since you put the yellow, it's not transparent anymore. A little bit of white, so it's even less transparent. Touch a midnight black. And the midnight black gives it a little tiny purplish cast. So, let's go up here. Using little crisscross strokes. Now, this is almost the same color as the background. This is almost the same color. Now, okay, now one thing. Grab your knife here and just get that out of there. Okay? Get that little one out. And now, you can go back in with your finger and put it back in. So, there you go. That just removes a little bit of excess, so let me try to blend it. Oh, that's smudge everywhere. Okay. Now I'm gonna go into our alizarin crimson. Right into some alizarin crimson. Alizarin crimson is not transparent. Touch of dark sienna. A little more. And some sap green in there too. Sometimes I accidentally put these colors in here. And it just... not good. Alright. I'm gonna make the little background sky here. Push across these. Maybe add a little white in there. It's too dark. Much too dark. Now make a little pink, grab some bright red. Into that. Go back up in here. Now it's a little brighter than the original color we had a couple seconds ago. When you look at your sunset, you will see brush strokes. On the camera, it doesn't look like I have too many brush strokes. But in reality, man, this is full of brush strokes right now. This is full of brush strokes right now. Alright, after that, we're going to go into some also Van Dyke Brown. Van Dyke Brown, touch a Thalo Blue. Touch of Prussian blue and go after your lizard and crimson. Sneaky, huh? Some dark sienna. Give a little extra color. And some white just to show its true color. I mean, it's not really showing its true color, but whatever. You can see that. Bright red. Bright red, bright red. Just a little bit. Now, this is a very dark. Almost a, you know what? Thalo blue. I want a lavender. I want a lavender. I want a lavender. There we go. So we have a nice little lavender. Just put a touch of sap green in there. And just a little. Well, it should look black. If that happens, just put some white in here. Brighten it up a little bit. And go out here again. Just cover this dark. Go back in your light. There. One thing that'll help you in the wet on wet technique. Get yourself a big palette. Because if you have a teeny palette, I'll show you. If you have a teeny palette like this, get at least a 20 by 20 palette. This is a 18 by 20. This is a 18 by 24. No, this is probably 16. I don't know. That's the clock. That's the clock singing. Blender brush. If you do this with a 2-inch brush, the bristles are too tough and they'll ruin everything. Blender soft, nice blender brush. Nice soft blender brush. And I'll blend this all out. You know what? This is what you can do. Grab the 2-inch brush and work into this light area here. Eyes. Go over here. Blend that out. Now you can blend this till you can't tell one color starts and the next color stops. Then we go into dark lavender. We're gonna go into here. And there you go. Blender brush. You know what? I gotta blend down here too so it looks soft. So it looks very soft and very, very soft down here. There we go. That's a soft little sky. I'm gonna blend this all out just to remove any of these. I'm just removing these strokes. All this does is remove your strokes. And sometimes if you do that, just tap in them. If you like make little cuts in the paint, just tap them and get rid of the strokes. These blender brushes will absolutely make a beautiful sky. There we go. That's a nice sky. Alright, let's make some little clouds. With that fan brush number 6, I'm gonna go into some titanium white. A little more titanium white. I just went right over the cad yellow. I just went right over the cad. So titanium white, just like in there. Now grab just a touch. Bright red. Just a little touch. And put some Prussian blue in there. Give it a bluish cast. A little lavender cast. And go right into your alizarin crimson, just a touch. I don't want a lot. Go into just a touch of Van Dyke brown. Touch. Van Dyke brown. It's a pretty transparent color. But that doesn't mean I want to give your whole world. So, touch of the blue. Now we're getting a touch of everything here. And this is how your color should look. Right there. Okay. Move the color into the bristles. Now, this is the really, really fun part. Drop the palette. This is how you can tell it's fun. You get to drop your palette. Okay. Now, hold the brush like this. See that? And this is how you make clowns. If you watch Bob Ross, you probably know this, but he does it with one hand. I do with this. I don't with both hands because I want to get extra crazy. Ready? Ready? This is how you get all your frustrated. Ready? Boom! Man, I've really been in there. Okay, I'm gonna get a little more color. Try not to go in front of the sun too much. But it's gotta happen sometimes. Maybe one more cloud. Oh, okay. I'm committed now. I have to do it right there. There we go. Maybe there's an orientation one coming out here. Like, maybe we don't know where that goes. We don't even care where it goes. Okay. There we go. Now, this is how you nice little clouds. I'll try to tap all the color out of my brush. I'm using a dirty brush. I recommend clean brush. Bottom. There we go. So down here too. So down here too. And some right here. Just the top corner of the brush, and I'm just blending these. There we go. Now, if you go up, it looks like it's raining upward. I don't know if you can see it, but and when you do this, you'll pull up little stringy things. That's okay. We'll get rid of them in a second. Makes beautiful clouds. And now we'll cross it. Cross it. I try not to go in front of the sun too much. There we go. Now I'll just start doing this here. And that's how you make some beautiful little clouds. I got some little things here. There we go. Beautiful little clouds. Now, we're going to indicate where we want our little sand to be. So with that, I'm gonna grab the knife and let's see, how do you make some dark sand? I got it. Alright. Cad yellow, bright red, and Indian yellow. There we go. A little more cad yellow. And some Indian yellow, bright red. We'll put some dark sea in it. Oops. I think I put too much. Don't want to red it too much. Need a little more yellow. Let's grab a touch of Van Dyke brown. And we'll put some white in here. You know, sand has a bright yellow. Has a brightish yellow color in it. A little more white in that. Make it a little brighter. There we go. That's a nice little sand color. Now I'm gonna grab some midnight black. And this is not too bright. This is kind of a dark scene. This sun is not going to be too much of that color. Maybe a little more cat yellow. And a little more white. A little bit more white. Lighten it up. Mix it. Let's grab a little more dark sienna in that. Now, there we go, we have a little muddy sand color. Okay. Alright, now, you know what, I'm going to use the knife. I'm going to cut a little roll of paint right on the edge of the knife. Where are you going with your little sand in here? I'm going to scratch out this whole thing out here. Remove. This one makes kind of an army-ish green color. Oh, I did this here, so now I'm committed. Oh. And this, and let's do this sand. As you go, you pick up more and more of the purplish lavender color. Now here we want a little darker, so a little more Van Dyke brown in that. A little paint, and put that in there. Or you could do this, scratch it out, put back in. Brush here, tap it in, boom, wasn't even there, nothing was ever there, okay, I'm going to take off the knife, take them off, I'm going to grab a little fan brush, and I'm going to I'll go right into some of the same color and just kind of, you know what, this would look better with a two inch brush. Now just paint this entire thing in, make it look like sand and all that, all those little beautiful things. Just live here. Take them, bend the bristles down, right on spot. I want a little more of the color. My mind, it just resembles some sand more than the grass. So in your mind, if this doesn't work, your mind just mix some yellow and some of the dark blues, and some greens. But I like this color. If you don't like it, you don't have to put it in. Pick away, make yourself happy. Make it yourself. You don't need it like mine. I just want
picked up some bright red tonight.
That's okay. That's alright.
I'm gonna grab the color I had on my brush. So block these. Put that in there.
Okay. 2-inch brush. Spread it out. Tapping it really helps. Okay. Now we'll go into the fun parts. We'll have a little water here. So we got this. Suppression blue. Halo blue.
Have a nice little color. I'm gonna cut off a little more paint. And just what I want my water right here. Water's right here. This is gonna be my water. I probably should have put my water in first. Brush and just tap it in. Sometimes go into your 2-inch brush into this color. There you go. Alright, now grab this. Little waves. So for that, go into some white. Blue. Little dark blue ocean color. Like that. I'm going to pretty touch liquid white. Just touch. Not too much, but not too little. Just to thin the paint down. You can use paint thinner, but this just lightens it up a little bit. Now, do this crisscross. Do this with little crisscrosses. And it'll begin looking like little waves. I like this little effect because it really, really looks like waves. Look at that. Beautiful little waves. Little, little bigger ones here. I want to make these bigger. Right here, I want these a little bigger. There you go. Now, very, very careful with this. Very. Take a 1-inch brush, go very gently, very, very gently, go across. No pressure, just touching it. Pretend like you're, oh, it's almost no pressure, almost, but you're adding some pressure to put the paint in. All right. Now, we're going to have little palm trees. So I'm going to grab this. Then I'm going to go into some sap green. Sap green, Prussian blue, table blue. If I had a little more time, I would have put a little more detail to the leaves, but
I'm running out of time, so touch a bright red on that. A little more black. Some of our ocean color we made.
We'll make the trunk of a little palm tree that lives right here. A little palm tree right there.
Okay, now let's go into our midnight black, Van Dyke brown. And a touch of dark sienna in there, and some lunar crimson. Maybe some more table blue. Work. This is the color we have. I have so much color on here. It's unbelievable. Okay. Now, you can do this by going like this. This is like some simple little palm trees. Now we're gonna grab some sap green, just some solid sap green and white. We'll highlight these right here. No, you want more white. Highlight these a lot. Highlight those little rascals. Go. Go. Sound effects help. Now, I'm gonna grab blue, the same blue color but white, but like lighter. And then, yeah, sound really help. Okay, I have a liner brush. I go right into some Van Dyke brown. Touch of sap green. Make little things, because you know palm trees have this little stuff here. Be careful with this. Be careful. I'm not going to sit here and paint palm trees all day. And now we're going to grab the sand color we made. I'm going to go right into this color. And we're going to make some shadow color. So right into the lavender and green. And some bright red. Man, my palette's a mess right now. Some red. There we go. This is the color you should get. Some muddy red. So I'm going to grab this. So much paint on my fan brush right now. Okay. And, so I have a rock. So I'm going to grab some phthalo blue. Right into our ocean color. And our palm tree color. Black. Van Dyke brown. Shoot, I'm using every color right now. Dark sienna. Using a lot of paint. I want little rocks to live. I want some right here. Right here. I want my little rocks to live right here. You don't have to put them there, you can put them somewhere else. Okay, now I'm gonna grab the same color. I'm gonna go into some white. Just to brighten it. And we'll highlight these. Firmly into the paint. No, I didn't. I just added some white in the color. And just highlight this. There we go. And you see, you have some little highlights. call that finished. And I hope to see you again. In the future. And you know what? One thing. This fan brush. Remember the purple color? Go right here. Make the same thing here too. And that'll look like little things right around it. Little stuff around it. There we go. Thank you, and I hope to see you again in the future. And I hope you have a super day. And see you next time. Bye-bye.